All right, come on, show me what you got.
Hey,
no.
Stop.
Hey, you good?
Yeah, I'll catch you later.
Okay, take it easy, eh?
My freshman season, my knee started to ache. I wasn't about to jeopardize my season, so I played through the pain. By March, it was getting hard to put weight on it. So I went to the doctor and he sent me to a specialist.
You have a rare osteogenic sarcoma, a kind of cancer of the bone. It's a tumor that most commonly develops in males ages 10 to 25. I've only seen two other cases.
What can we do about
it? I'm afraid it means immediate surgery. We're going to have to amputate the leg to stop the tumor from spreading.
Welcome to the real world, she said to me, condescendingly. Take a seat, take your life, blot it out in black and white. Well, I never lived the dream of the prom king or the drama queens. I'd like to think the best of me is still hiding up my sleeve. They love to tell you, stay inside the lines. But something's better on the other side.
But after that, what's the chance of survival?
If we follow up the surgery with a round of chemotherapy using a new experimental drug, I'd say the chance of survival is 50%. Without it would have only been 15.
I wanna run through the halls of my high school. I wanna scream at the top of my lungs. I just found out there's no such thing as the real world. Just a lie, you got to rise above.
It's Mars of surgery. It's crummy, kid, but you can either mope about it or you can fight it. I found this article that may be of some interest to you.
We'll try to save as much of the leg as we can. We know we need to amputate above the knee. We'll do this by isolating the major nerves and sectioning the muscles to detach them from their current location, all before we adjust the femur. You'll be with us in the hospital for a while so we can monitor your progress. You'll start rehab as soon as you're up for it. At that time, you'll be fitted with a prosthetic leg.
And all of our parents, they're getting older. I wonder if they wished for anything better. While their memories, tiny tragedies, they love to tell you, stay inside the lines. But something's better.
As the chemotherapy treatments went on, it became harder, much harder than losing my legs. But I loved the kids. When I was doing my physiotherapy in the children's ward, we'd egg each other on. They inspired me. A lot of them had it worse than I did. Then one day, I remembered the magazine that Coach had left me. They had an article about Dick Trom, an amputee who had just ran the New York City Marathon. I thought if he could do it, why couldn't I? I wasn't even sure I believed I could, but I started to think to myself, one day, I'm going to do something like that.
I am invincible.
I am invincible.
I am invincible.